The Vedas mention Agnihotra as a Jara Maryam Satra, which means a process that you should follow right from your birth until your death, because it is a great healing and purifying technique. For the performance of Agnihotra, you need some basic ingredients. First and most importantly, you need the semi-pyramid shaped copper vessel. It has to be made from copper because copper is a good conductor of heat and electricity. Secondly, you need dry cow dung. It has to be from the cow family. That means the cow, the bull and the calf. It comes in two different shapes and sizes. The round one, which is used extensively across India, and the rectangular biscuit sized cow dung, which is used in many parts of the world. Thirdly, you need unbroken, uncooked rice grains. Rice is a universal food. It is consumed in many cultures around the world and is available around the world. You need cow's ghee. It has to be from cow. It can't be from any other source. You need the local sunrise sunset timing. Now, you can go onto our website and download your local sunrise and sunset timesheet for the next 100 years. Or you can download the Agnihotra app on your phone, which gives real-time, location-based sunrise and sunset timing and also gives you a prompt before Agnihotra. The final most important thing that you need for the performance of Agnihotra are two simple Sanskrit mantras. They are so simple that even a small 5-year-old child can recite them with ease. They are, for sunrise, you chant Suryaya Swaha, Suryaya Idam Namama, Prajapataye Swaha, Prajapataye Idam Namama. In this mantra, what we are saying is that, O sun, like you are brilliant and wonderful and full of radiant energy, me too, I am also a part of this same radiant energy, and may this radiance also shine through me. And the sunset, you say, Agnaye Swaha, Agnaye Idam Namama, Prajapataye Swaha, Prajapataye Idam Namama. In this mantra, what you are saying is that, O Agni, O fire, you are beautiful, radiant, and full of energy, as am I. I am also part of your energy. Your radiance or your energy may also shine through me, and may me and my life also become beautiful and radiant. So in these two mantras, what you are actually saying is that you want to be awakened to a new state of reality. You want to awaken to a new state of being, where you are not limited by your conditioning anymore. You're free, you're in your true essence. You can unleash your true creative potential and really channelize energy that lies dormant within you. Now let us begin the actual performance of Agnihotra. Agnihotra can be done both indoors and outdoors. Just make sure that the area where Agnihotra is being performed is not littered with any trash. Find a flat surface to do Agnihotra so that it is comfortable and doesn't disturb you with the tilt. You can both sit down like I am in this lotus pose, or you can sit on a table and chair and do Agnihotra as well. To perform Agnihotra, you get the Vishwa starter kit. This comes with all the ingredients necessary to perform Agnihotra. Now let us begin this process. The first thing that you see is the Agnihotra information booklet. It has a lot of information about the performance of Agnihotra, the process, all the important information that you need to keep this process going on a daily basis in your homes. Now what you get is the most essential part of doing Agnihotra, the copper pyramid. Take out all the items, place the copper stand on the flat bottom. If you are doing it on a wooden floor, make sure that you use some kind of an insulating material like a piece of tile or a piece of stone so that the floor doesn't get any damage. Also make sure that there are no flammable items around Agnihotra performance, because there is going to be a live flame here and you don't want to damage any other item around you. Make sure that when you are, if there are children in the home, after the performance of Agnihotra, keep the Agnihotra vessel at a height so that the children don't touch it, because it stays warm for quite some time. Now, once you have put the stand on the ground, place the Agnihotra pyramid on top of it. Make sure that it fits perfectly and there is no tilt or any imbalance, because if the fire is lit and there is a slight tilt, there are chances that some embers of the flame might fall off or fall out from the pot. Next, you need to take cow dung. Always make sure that you place one flat piece of cow dung at the bottom. This is necessary because the piece at the bottom will help the other pieces to catch fire with ease. After that, you can organize the cow dung in the pot. Place one piece at a time on each side. After that, take a piece of cow dung and using the spoon that you get in the kit, apply some ghee to its tip. You need to be sure to apply enough ghee because this ghee is going to help this piece of cow dung catch fire. Also add ghee in the Agnihotra pot before the flame is lit, because if it's too cold or if it's too moist outside, it is going to take time for the Agnihotra fire to be lit. Now this piece is ready. Take the Agnihotra copper dish that you get in the kit. Take 2 pinches of uncooked, unbroken rice grains in this copper dish and add a little ghee, just maybe 2 or 3 drops, that is enough, and mix it together and make 2 approximate halves. So now our oblations are ready, our pot is ready. This process of making the Agnihotra kit ready has to be started 5 minutes before the actual performance time. So if say the morning sunrise Agnihotra at your location is 6 o'clock, you start this process at 5:55. This helps giving you enough time to make everything ready. The fire can be lit at the right precise time and then you are in time to offer the oblations in the fire. Now let us actually light the Agnihotra fire. To light this Agnihotra fire, you cannot use any kerosene, petrol or any gasoline-based products because this is a purifying healing technique. You don't want to use any pollutants to start this fire. You can use natural herbal ingredients like the camphor or the gugul, which itself has a lot of medicinal value. Or like I just did, you can just use a piece of cow dung, apply a little ghee to it and put a lit match to it, it catches fire, and then just place it in the center of the pile. Now let us actually do this. Just hold the match near the piece of cow dung that has been applied the cow's ghee. You can see that it has already caught fire. Now gently place it in the center of the pile. Like that. Slowly the fire will spread and all the pieces will catch fire. Now, looking at the local sunrise and sunset time sheet, find out the actual performance time. Let's say it is, like I said, 6 o'clock. Looking at the watch, determine the actual time. Now we will do the process of morning Agnihotra. At sunrise, you chant 2 simple Sanskrit mantras and offer the oblations in the fire. The mantras are Suryaya Swaha, Suryaya Idam Namama, Prajapataye Swaha, Prajapataye Idam Namama.
For sunset Agnihotra, remove the ash in a separate bag or a bin, arrange the cow dung as we did and light it on fire, make the oblations ready and exactly at local sunset timing, utter the 2 simple Sanskrit mantras.
Now we will do the sunset Agnihotra. Agnaye swaha, agnaye idamna mama, prajapataye swaha, prajapataye idamna mama. This concludes the process of Agnihotra. All it takes is 5 minutes. After this, you can sit here and meditate until the flames go down. Or if you are in a rush, if you have to go off to your job or drop your kids at school, make sure that you place the burning Agnihotra pot in a safe location. You do not want anything that is flammable to touch this. It is going to be warm for a long time, at least 20 to 30 minutes. So either place it on a height where the flames are not bothering any other thing, or place it in a garden or in a balcony so that the smoke and the flames are safe in a safe location. Agnihotra is a healing technique. The continuous performance of Agnihotra sets in motion a healing cycle, a healing wheel, so to say. The energies emanating from this process heal everything that it touches. It is beneficial for human, animal and plant life. Before sunset Agnihotra, make sure to collect the ash in a separate bin or in a separate bag and store it, because Agnihotra ash has been known to have medicinal value for human, animal and plant use. So do not throw away the Agnihotra ash. Make sure that you collect it and retain it for future use. Agnihotra has been practiced by millions of people around the world today, and everybody has given us a feedback that Agnihotra has changed their lives for good. It has made them happy, it has made them healthier, and also it has made them find a new direction in life. Agnihotra is something that adds a lot of value to your life, so we urge you to take up this practice and make your own lives happy, healthy and vibrant. Thank you.